once I've realised I've had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cheaters, hey man, how about give me a fair go? You know, it's not fair. The way I look at it is if someone's cheating and he kills someone while they're competing, you know, the repercussions should be like a criminal offence. If he's got a family, he's going to look after the family. Or, hey man, just give him a fine and a 2 year suspension.
They could fucking
maim him. Would that suffice though? But even maiming or killing, would that suffice though?
No.
No, of course not. Well, of course it fucking wouldn't. Criminal proceedings should pass on. I mean, the last time it happened...
Can you explain... Sorry, because there's people watching, they don't know, like, say, for example, when you're saying they're cheating, can you explain what you mean by cheating and whatnot?
Well, what I know from cheating is you get better sleep, you're a lot stronger...
No, no, but why? Cheating how?
Steroids, you know, performance enhancers. Okay, cool. Yeah. That's why they say call it PED. Well, look, pure example, that dickhead fucking bike rider. 7 years of winning the Tour de France, 7 years of building a $200-300 million empire, you know, 7 years of suing people, of lying, building an empire, of cheating. And the way I look at it is not that. And I think it goes down to the 17th person that wasn't cheating.
No, it's top 30 in the Tour de France. I reckon it's top 30.
So the 29th guy is the one that wasn't cheating. So at the end of the way I look at it, it's not these guys. It's not about, I mean, Lance Armstrong cheated, yeah. But all these guys have cheated. So the one that hasn't cheated, their families missed out, their kids missed out on better everything. You know, why are we rewarding these fucking dickheads that cheat when we should be putting them and saying, hey man, you did something wrong, you cheated, dickhead, you took a shortcut, you're a cheating shortcut motherfucker, you shouldn't be here. Why don't we put them on pedestals?
What? So when you...
Bro, in society, if someone does wrong, he does something wrong, where do we put them?
Yeah,
in jail. This is fighting. This is fighting at the highest level. We shouldn't praise guys that they get here and they're constantly cheating. I mean, all the guys that I used to respect, I was like, man, I don't have no time with it. You shouldn't be on a pedestal because you're a fucking shortcut taker.
When you went through K1, you fought dudes for sure. Pride, 100%. And in the UFC, you fought in the UFC.
No, do you think I'm sick of it? Fucking earth. The last 4 or 5 guys I've fought, I've come to the realization, you know what? This is supposed to be the cleanest fucking sport of the world. You guys are supposed to look after this. I came from that area of all these cheaters and I'm here now and you've given me 4 in a row. And then the last guy, the Alistair, I remember the dickhead, they forced me to take him. And I didn't want to do it. I said, just put a clause in, then I'll do it. And the clause was supposed to say, if he's caught cheating, take all his money off him. They don't have to give it to me, give it to your fucking self. Just take it off him so he makes no financial gain, so you can't go and do another cap. Because they're rewarding guys that are cheating. I don't understand why they don't just say, okay, here's the clause. You know, what are they to lose?
How obvious is the difference when you fight a dude like that that's obvious?
It's taken me so long to realize, because I'm quite stubborn and dumb sometimes. Like I said, I've come from the era of Pride and K1. It's taken me, even this year, it's taken me so long to realize. But you know, for me, it's like, I understand, okay, broken hand, I look at it sometimes, broken toe is like one guy cheating. Okay, it's probably just him. We'll forget about it, yeah. The second guy cheating, okay, nah, sweet. Give me his bonus, okay. Third guy. You know, I said, fuck is going on here?
I'm getting sick of this.
I'm losing fights that I shouldn't be losing to guys that have got the advantages. Yeah, and then the worst was Brock Lesnar. Because he said, oh, hey man, we'll get this fucking juice monkey and we'll give him the 4 month waiver. I'm like, fuck.
Can you explain that?
I don't even know. The whole thing was fishy from the start. They were negotiating way before the sale. But you know, at the end of the day, they say, we'll give him a 4 month waiver. Why does he fucking get a 4 month waiver?
100%.
I mean, fuck, I've got to do the testing. Why is he? He's been the most tested guy in the world. That fucking Dana says, yeah, right, buddy. The fucking dickhead. Dickhead. I shouldn't have said it.
And was it when you fought Lesnar, did he feel different to other human beings?
Fuck, I'm like on my tippy toes and he's got me up in the mid one, and he's lift me up. I'm on my tippy toes and the fence, like, fuck bro, I don't know which way to. He's got control. And I'm quite strong. I'm like, this guy's a lot stronger than me. And like I said, I mean, he hits like a girl, but his strength is just amazing.
He doesn't hit hard?
Oh, I mean, you're talking about, I got a coconut here, bro. I mean, you know, fucking cracks this motherfucker. I mean, well, you know, a few of them do. But, you know, he hits, I just, if I was his physique, his strength, he would have died. I would have killed that motherfucker. If I was cheating, I said, I'm going to kill and crack your head open like a fucking Easter egg.
Did you?
Well, it's true though. It's bullshit.
That is terrifying. Imagine Mark.
No, I'd like to be on the serious side, man. I'm gonna kill that motherfucker. And say, you know what? Just give me a fine for 2 years. And yeah. I'd put my fucking fist through his skull, man. I would like to do that.
Imagine the power.
Do you think? Would you want to fight those guys again?
If they put on the clause. Clean. Yeah. If you put on a clause and says, you know, if he gets caught cheating. You know, I mean, I've asked a few times for this. You know, the company should be on my side, and it should be legitimately. And they should be saying, "This is an honest sport. We are mainstream. We are, you know, we've got the best athletes, the cleanest athletes. This is fighting. People could die. Someone's gonna die sooner or later."
People don't realize that because they see the people getting popped hot for certain things, and it's like, especially after fights, it's like, this guy just did 12 weeks of camp at superhuman strength, stamina, cardio, recovery, and then fought a dude and inflicted real harm and injury on this guy.
That's correct.
Like I'm not the same as I left that fight now because of that guy. Because
you got fucking injured.
And then he gets a fine and 2 years off.
That's what I don't understand.